this group, I couldn't find a really good friend to support my ministry, my dream, and my call. Anyway, it was really demanding, I remember. And mostly 2012 was the worst year. So every time I woke up and I just prayed, God, do I really need to do that? Do I really need to maintain this ministry here and that kind of prayer? Then surprisingly, God just answered less than 1 second, and then yes, I called you to this church. So I just answered that whenever I pray, God just bless me to have power to maintain this ministry, and bless me to survive one more day. That's my prayer. So when I come to this class, class name is Facing the First Pastorate. So I was thinking that I think we need to ask questions to God all the time about why. And once Adam Hamilton said, I believe, he said, we need to ask 3 questions. Why me? Why this church? Why here? When we start our ministry. So I think questioning this kind of question to God all the time just help us to realize why should we start this church? Why should we be in charge of this congregation? That kind of stuff. So I think that's really important and meaningful. And that clearly lead us to think about what will be the really healthy relationship between God and me. From my perspective, ministry is a kind of journey to know more about myself and God as well, in the midst of our friends in the ministerial setting. So if we don't have any kind of clear idea, why should I start this trip? Why should I interpret this? If we don't have an answer, clear answer for that, we may not, we may stumble anytime, and we may not have any, the energy from God that makes me sustain, makes me survive every day, every week. So, from my perspective, being a minister, it's not just being a mediator between God and the people of God. But firstly, we need to think about myself and the clear understanding about the relationship between God and me. So if I can stand on firm ground of clear call, like the answer that why should I start this ministry? Why should I be in charge of this kind of ministry here? We have a clear answer for that, then God answer, I believe. So I think this is my favorite book, The Imitation of Christ. It says, part 1, chapter 3, at the day of judgment, we shall not be asked what we have read, but what we have done, not how eloquently we have spoken, but how holily we have believed. So we proclaim the message in the pulpit all the time like this. You should be living like this, but then we should not, sometimes we miss the whole idea of how should I be the clear with a pure heart, with a humble heart, and then with a clear call of this kind of ministry. So I just want to say that we're going to ask questions whenever you God respond to me in a clear answer, then you are there. Then if you want to know more about my ministry, then you can visit r5communitychurch.com, and then we have a clear section about creation story, and then you will see how I started this ministry. stuff, and then just visit our Facebook page as well, and just don't forget to click the like button.